d4, knight f6, c4, g6, knight c3, bishop g7, e4, d6, knight f3, short castle. Bishop e2, e5, short castle, knight c6, d5, knight e7, b4. Let's check what happens after knight e8, and if he plays here, the main move, which is knight d2 here, in this position. So the idea is very clear. After c5, he wants to go to knight c4, and the only good point for us is that we don't have to play h6 anymore, so we can play immediately f5. Another idea, just to enrich your vocabulary in this position, we can get back to our ideas with from Lanka's a5. There is a trick here. If, for example, he plays bishop a3, you can take on b4, and after bishop b4, c5, unexpected. Unexpectedly, this bishop doesn't have any square, so he has to take on c6, and after knight c6 already to give us this bishop or the control over d4 square. So I mean, this is already very comfortable situation. Also on the c6 we can take here way pawn on c6 is also good. So after a5, usually what they do, they take on a5. We take rook a5, and usually the problem was considered that after knight b3 or rook a8, they can play c5 immediately. This is the only issue here to discuss, because if he doesn't play c5, let's say he does any normal move, let's say bishop e3, then after c5 we close the position and we have absolutely normal situation. So c5, this moment need to remember. We should meet with this counterattack with c6. You see, both pawns are protected by our knights, so there is no fear that we can lose control in this battle. After c6, cd6, knight gets to d6, another gets to knight c6, to the c6, and after bishop e3, b6, we have absolutely normal situation. Our next move would be bishop b7, finish the development. If he goes knight d5, then we have here knight d4 with simplifications, because on e4 also is hanging. If he goes for the pawn after bishop b6, then we take on the bishop, queen d6, rook d8. And on knight d5 we have queen f2, nice trick. Otherwise we have full compensation here. After queen c5 we most probably should take and put the knight to d4, and is the compensation. Well, that's about a5. On knight d2, anyway, our main idea of course is to play a5. Here he might play f3 is the main line, but also should be checked the move a4 here. On a4, first I have to mention again we have this a5 idea always possible for us. For example, b5, rook a5, knight b3. Of course, if not knight b3, then we would play c5. But after knight b3, rook a8, c5. We can take on e4 and bring the knight to f5. After a4 main move, it's knight f6, asking for f3. If they play f3, then we have similar positions with the previous chapter. But if he ignores us, if he plays a5, then we should check one time how to attack this position when why didn't play f3. f4, c5, g5, a6, b6. On a6 we play b6. On bishop a3 we go with g4. Knight c4, knight g6. So this is more or less step. It's very similar to the main lines. Here, they, of course, the target is the bishop on e2. Potentially, we want to play at one moment f3 and knight f4. King h1, rook f7, bishop d3, f3 anyway, g3. And it looks like in the beginning that we don't have mating attack, but actually it's very long term attack. So in the long term, of course, our plan will be to attack on the king with, on the h-file. h5, b5, bishop f8, c6, h4, ignoring his threats, b6, ab, ab. Very nice position already. Knight h5, queen e1, cb6, knight b5, and now already the attack is ready, so we play rook h7, c7, queen g5. How to continue this attack? Rook d1, hg, fg. And before we get into final combinations with knight g3, we have to bring one more piece to the attack. It's knight gf4, gf4, e4, bishop c1, rook a2, rook d2, and knight g3, winning. Well, that was the clear example how to attack in the positions when he doesn't play f3. If he does play f3 on 14th move, then we have another typical type of attacks. Then we do play after f3 knight g6. If he goes knight c4, then first rook f7, of course. This is always good to have this bishop f8 in order to defend on d6. The pawn, this is very typical setup. g4. Okay, we saw when we played the g4, now we will see how to play against g4. In this situation, if he plays g4, then h5, h3, it's a must for him. Bishop goes to f8, rook goes to h7. Bishop h3, rook h7. So we want to launch an attack on the h-file, king g2. Bishop e7. Rook c1, bishop d7. a6, b6. c6, bishop e8. What I can say only about this situation is that his attack already stopped for sure, and for us it's still not finished yet. So what are our main ideas? Of course, it's to triple on the h file one day, maybe, or double at least, and after taking on g4 to try all this kind of sacrifices on g4, e4, and then f3 and so on. But usually black white should bring some knight to f2 and to protect also. Maybe that would be end to draw. That was against the g4 when he closes the position. That happened after knight c4. Also knight g6, he can go here a6 immediately. We would play b6 and typical jump for him for his bishop b5. It's interesting that we shouldn't be stubborn in our ideas to, for example, to not exchange the bishop. This bishop on b5, it's very strong. He goes to c6, so better to exchange it, because we have enough power to for our attack on that side. So bishop d7, provoking. If he exchange, we have very comfortable queen d7, and the play with g4 will go very smoothly. So we provoke c6 again. Of course, we put the bishop to e8. The position is closed. It's only us who can attack. If he will defend, it's good. If not, then it's draw. Sorry, if he defends, it's draw. If not, then it's win for us. It's two-way ticket. We are near to the end. Last line after f5, what we have to examine here is f3. And this move f3 and the all typical attacks what we have after this. After f3, of course, we go f4, c5, g5. That's a nice picture. Knight c4, knight g6. So how we place our pieces? a4. First, we start with rook f7. Not knight f6, not h5, first rook f7. This is the most safe way for us. Let's say bishop a3. Second, we put the bishop to f8. a5 and h5. So now, if, for example, he tries to play on the c file with rook c1, then rook g7, king h1, and knight f6. What is the point? Why here knight f6? It's possible because the bishop on f8 already protects very well on d6, and the rook on g7 also keeps an eye on c7. So, beside the fact this rook attacks on the king side, he also controls the 7th rank. This is also important in some lines. Here he is most probably his attack is b5. If he is slow, like makes moves like rook c2, then we know what to do. It's already g4 a must here. Rook g1, g3. That's the attempt, you know, to defend this square, this pawn on h3 by playing bishop f1. It's not enough because here we have a brilliant attacking move, knight g4. This really destroys the position. I mean, whatever he does, we will open h file and simply will mate the king. So rook c2 is slow. And if he is trying to be fast after b5, still g4 is coming, b6, ab, ab, and g3. That's the way to attack, especially thanks to the rook to g7. Immediately we launch very strong attack against his king. bc7, exactly in this situation, rooks get to c7, because the queen was attacked, queen e1, and now very funny and easy move for our understanding, another tactical idea for black, and the easy one is knight d5, in order to bring the queen to h4 and to mate the king. Well, last line. If he 17 goes b5 after h5 immediately, then we have to remember this moment. The pawn on c5 is hanging, bc5, b6, ab, ab, cb, queen b3, and we can use our rook for protecting the pawn with rook a6, rook fb1, and another funny way of defending the pawn. So the two rooks defend from the 6th ranked pawn, and it's a reasonable position for black. So let's have some conclusions on this 92 line in Bayonet with 98. We should go with f5. We have in mind always this move a5. It's always possible for a change to play, but f5, of course, is the main idea. We are provoking f3. If he doesn't play f3, sometimes after knight f6, we can go with f4, g5, g4, having in mind this attack with knight g6, f3, knight f4, and so on. If he does play f3, then the attack is very typical, but before starting some active, of course we play first f4 and g5, but before going for some crazy idea, we put the knight to g6, rook to f7, bishop to f8, and only after that we prepare the attack with h5, knight f6, g4, or rook g7, g4, depends on the situation already. But, I mean, on computer levels, on correspondence chess, all these attacks prove to be very strong and very nice for black.